Hello guys, in this video I wanted to do a video response to some of the questions on the central line video. One of the first questions right here is Jesus Suarez was, what is the procedure for? Well, the procedure is done because we need IV access on patients who are very sick usually. We try to get peripheral access, but we were unable to because the patient has very small veins, he was very dehydrated. After multiple attempts, 3, 4, 5 times trying to get an IV, and they call the doctor in to see what we can do. Usually we try to do external jugular veins, but he was so dehydrated, they were collapsed, so we couldn't access that. Emergently, we would have to put an IO, an intraosseous line, if he was really, really sick and we didn't have time to put a central line. But a central line is a big IV that acts the major vessels of the body, usually the femoral, which is in the groin, the subclavicular, and the internal jugular. And then we put this access line so we can aggressively hydrate him, give him IV medications that need to be on bigger veins, and things like that. The other, here there's another question by 7nick6. I know PIC and centrals are two totally different things, but can you tell me why one is chosen over the other? Are they both used for the same purpose? Well, the answer is yes, they're used for the same purpose in the sense that we do this in people that need prolonged or special medications through the IV. PIC lines are meant to stay there for a month at a time. Central lines, no. Central lines only stay for a few days, maybe a week. We can have tops. PIC lines, even though they introduce peripherally, they go all the way central into the major vessels. So PIC lines we put in the ER when we can't get anything else, but the patient's not at risk that he needs a central line and go to the ICU. We expect the hospitalization to be long because of infection or because of comorbidities. Or the patient's leaving the hospital with a PIC line because they need IV antibiotics daily for months or weeks or something like that. I had a lot of suggestions of doing the videos without the music. Sorry about that. The Darth Valen here, a shout out to him. He always comments and it's great to see his comments. Chris Adonowski, what is this done for? I just answered that. And there was one here about, Levi 90. Nice one. Here we used to shave the patient before any major procedure. Why did you not shave him? Well, the answer is you definitely don't want to shave them, but you might want to use clippers to cut the hair close. Honestly, I've never done that for a central line. I wasn't trained like that. I never seen anybody do it. But I went to our former chief of staff, who's the chief of general surgery, and asked him the question, do you ever clip them? Do you ever shave the groin for a central line? And he had to think about it for a second, but he said if the patient's really, really hairy, he does clip him. He used like the barbershop clippers, but medical grade, kind of clip the hair really close to the skin. And the reason is not because the hair gets on the way or because the hair itself leads to infection, but because when you're done putting the central line, you have to put an occlusive dressing to prevent infection from getting into the line and into the vein and into the system of the body. So by putting this occlusive dressing, it really needs to be tight against the skin. And if you have a lot of hair, the hair is going to lift it up and then infection can set in. So the answer is, yeah, we should have clipped this. But to be honest, I went around to my ER doctors and asked them, have you ever shaved or clipped a groin than a patient that's hairy? And all of them said no. So very good suggestion by Levi. Definitely something I'll teach to my doctors that we should do in very hairy areas, to go ahead and clip that area. Not because of the immediate risk, but delayed risk because of the occlusive dressing maybe falling out or not sticking enough to that groin. So that's very useful. Hey, I thank you all for the all the good comments. I do appreciate them. It keeps me wanting to do more and see some very intelligent questions on my channel, and makes me want to study and learn more about medicine. So keep it going, guys. Bye-bye.